So once you feel like you have your utilities in order, your moving company in order, I would highly recommend like a moving day suitcase or box, because with the craziness of moving, even if you have your friends and family moving you, the reality is when you're moving in a day, you're probably gonna wanna sleep in your new house. So I highly recommend having a suitcase with like your pajamas and all of your important things in there. Have a box with like toilet paper and some cleaning solution, trash bags, you know, snacks, whatever you need, because even if you're ordering pizza and grabbing some beer or whatever you're doing, like it is very difficult to go through all those boxes, even if they're well labeled, to find, okay, where's my contact solution, my toothbrush? You wanna have all that stuff almost as if you're going out of town, because it's gonna take you a couple days to get that all together. On moving day, I think it's also super important to plan ahead with whether it's kids, pets, whatever you have, to book that boarding for a couple of days. You know, if you need to send your kids to the grandparents or get a babysitter involved, because little kids running around with all the movers is craziness. So try to plan ahead as much as possible. Some things if you are selling a house that I would recommend doing, you know, in advance, because it gets really hectic at the end, is, you know, get copies of your keys, your garage openers, you know, any of those owner manuals. Even though most of them are online, a lot of us have them in our drawers or wherever, just leave those for the sellers, because that could be super useful for them. And on moving day, you're just not gonna know where anything is. Once you're all moved in and have a second to breathe, the best thing to do is really to contact all of your service providers that you need a change of address. So one of the big things is you need your new license. It's super easy to go on to Department of Driver Services. They have an app and all the things, and you can just request a change of address. It's free. They usually mail it to you within a week or so. That's super important. If you need a proof of address, that's the first thing they're going to ask for. Also contact your insurance company, credit card companies, your bank, anything that you're going to get a bill for that you may not have thought of before that was going to your prior home. That's gonna be super important to contact them about. Once you've moved in, it's really important to look back at your inspection report and see if there were any items that you weren't able to negotiate with the seller that you wanted to get done. You know, things like chimney cleaning, that's perfect for summer, springtime, before that, you know, before they get busy. There's very available right now because no one's using their fireplaces. I always recommend to clients air duct cleaning. It's insanely disgusting, and you should do it on every single house. It's just one other way to clean the house out, especially if they had pets or if you were getting any work done on your home, like the dust and everything. I just think it's a really nice thing to have cleaned out. If you want any spiritual people to come, bless your home, whatever you need to do, I would start booking those people. Get your cleaners out there, your yard people. If you want to start booking, if you need a new fence, an electric fence for your animals, whatever you need, I would start booking those out. Because again, all these vendors, especially I feel like post-COVID, everyone is insanely booked up, that I would prep them as soon as you can move in to get them booked up ahead of time to make sure that your home is as ready as possible when you move in. And here at In Town Collective, we know it's a stressful process. That's why we are here. We have an entire vendor list. Our entire team is here who have bought and sold homes before, and we know what you're going through. So if there's anything that you need, please reach out to us. We are here to help you. Even after the closing, we are not gone. Like, we are very available for you, that anything that you could need. We know that, you know, you're going through a lot right now. It's very stressful and you probably need a break. So if there's anything that we can do, please reach out.